All right, today we will start to address one of the first elements of a short story, and that is the element of character. Characters are divided into two main types. The first type is a static or flat character. It is a character that does not change, that does not develop, the kind of character who does not learn anything throughout the short story. And then we have characters that are dynamic. A dynamic character or a round character changes from one particular position to another position within the short story. For example, Spider-Man has certain behavioral patterns, certain outlooks, but Spider-Man wasn't always Spider-Man. Spider-Man in the beginning was Peter Parker, and Peter Parker is a very different kind of thing from Spider-Man. Peter Parker is a different behavior. Peter Parker is a different character altogether. If you are familiar with your comic books, which you don't have to be, but if you are, or if you've seen the recent Spider-Man movies, you might recall that Peter Parker was a bit of a nerd. He was a poor, intelligent kid, but he was poor. He lived with his aunt and uncle. He had been orphaned by his parents who had died when he was young. So Peter Parker is very different from Spider-Man. But as Spider-Man, though they are one and the same, as Spider-Man, he has different behavioral patterns. Another kind of character that's related to both, though it doesn't always exist, is a symbolic character. So here, with our festively attired potato, we see the artificial fangs, the rather silly looking ears, the comical hat. This is indicative of a time in the autumn when we all dress up as scary vampire monsters, or maybe as celebrities, or other things. It's indicative of Halloween, and so occasionally we will have a symbolic character. However, a flat character doesn't necessarily mean it's a boring character. From Star Wars, any of the movies, we have this character, the beloved R2-D2. R2-D2 always functions, always behaves, always has sort of the same outlook on things. From movie to movie, from scene to scene, R2-D2 never acts differently. He's the loyal robot droid. And he always contains that particular outlook. So, to review, we have two broad, and then within those two broad categories, sometimes a third category of character. We have the dynamic character, which is the character who can change. We have the static character, which is the character that remains the same throughout the entire work. Doesn't have a realization, doesn't change from being good to bad or bad to good, just always remains the same. And either a dynamic or a static character can be also a symbolic character representing a particular group or a particular belief throughout the short story. So those are our two broad and one narrow types of characters.